Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you how you can create this abstract render in Blender with geometry nodes. So let's get started. First hit Shift A and add a circle. Go into edit mode, press E, S and Shift Z and scale it up like this. Now press R and type in 3. Now press Alt and click on this inner circle here. Press F3 and type in grid fill. Alt select this circle here. Go up here to proportional editing and enable it. Press G and Z and scroll the mouse wheel like this. With proportional editing still enabled and the outer ring selected, press R twice and rotate it like this. Make sure it doesn't intersect with itself anywhere. Go back into object mode and add a solidify modifier. Set the fitness to 0.05. Go to geometry nodes and click on new. Now add an extrude mesh node. Put it here. Add a mask wave texture. Plug the height into the offset. Set the scale to 0.025. Add a subdivision surface node. Put that here. I recommend that you set it to 2, but you can of course leave it at 1. Duplicate the extrude mesh node and plug the height into the offset again. Add a set shade smooth node. Let's put that here and add a set material node. Let's also duplicate the subdivision surface node and put it here. Go to the material properties and create a new material. Select the material here. Now go to shading. Go into rendered view. I recommend that you use cycles. Under the work properties, go to color and set it to sky texture. Set the sun elevation to 5 and the sun rotation to 45. Let's set arrow dust in the zone to 3. Delete the principal BSDF and add a mix shader. Plug the shader into the surface and add a glass shader. Plug the BSDF into the shader here. Let's also add subsurface scattering. Plug that into the bottom socket here. For the color, I'm going to choose a light blue. Simply drag and drop it down here. Add a color ramp. Plug the color into the factor of the mix shader. Bring the black into somewhere around here. Press Ctrl T. And let's use the object output. Delete the image texture, connect the vector to the factor, hit Shift A and add a wave texture, put it here, set it to rings and set it to Y. Let's plug the vector into the scale and the distortion as well. Set the scale of the mapping to 1.5. Let's take the color of the wave texture and plug it into the roughness of the glass BSDF. Go back to layout mode. Let's position our view somewhere around here, for example. Hit Shift A and add a camera. Control Alt 0 to go into camera view. Go up here and enable depth of field. Now hit Shift A and add an empty plane axis. Enable snapping and select face project. Press G and I'm going to put it somewhere around here. This is going to be our focus object for the camera. Select the camera, enable depth of field, and select the empty. Set the abstract to 0.5 and the blades to 16. Now if we select the empty again and move it around, as you can see, the focus of the camera will follow the empty. Let's disable this again and set it back to increment. Go to the render properties. I recommend that you set the samples as high as possible. I'm going to set them to 2560. Now go to film and make it transparent and go to color management, set the view transform to filmic and the look to very high contrast. Let's also enable transparent glass. Go to compositing and add a denoise node. You also need to enable use nodes and enable denoising data. I'm also going to add an alpha over node. Put it here, plug the image into the bottom. And basically what this is going to do, it's going to enable me to change the color of the area that is transparent. So now the background will be white, but I want it to be black. Go to the output properties and select a resolution that we want. I'm going to use JPEG as the file format and set the quality to 100%. Now let's save and press F12 to render the image. If you liked this tutorial, you are probably also going to like the one that is on screen now. I'll see you next time.